Hi everyone, in this tutorial, we will create a scroll-based animation using GSAP scroll trigger. After the text appears, images and a video fade in with random positions and a staggered effect. The animation speed depends on how fast or slow we scroll. Let's get started. First, let's look at the HTML. We add the CDN to use both GSAP and scroll trigger. We have a section with the class container. There is a description, 6 images, and 1 muted looping video. This section will be pinned while scrolling, and the animations will play as we scroll. Let's move on to CSS. In this part, we'll create a radial gradient background, center the elements, and make them responsive. We style the text with a custom font using Google Fonts. We set the container's height to 100 viewport height to create enough space for the animations. We use Flexbox to center the content and add a soft radial gradient to the background. The text has a soft color and is hidden at first by setting its opacity to 0. The images and video have the same size, rounded corners, and soft shadows. We make the layout responsive using media queries. We don't need the opacity here, but I add it to show the text width on small screens. The images and the video will also hidden at first. Now let's add animation using GSAP. This event listener ensures the entire page is loaded before running the animations. Then we get the container, description, all images and video into variables. This helps us find the video element from the list of images and video. We also set the description's opacity to 0 to prevent it from flashing on load. Each image and video gets a small left or right rotation based on its index. This function gives random x and y values between two numbers, changing in steps of 10. So each image and video appear in a slightly random position. We apply a rotation and random position to each item before the animation starts. Now we build a GSAP timeline with scroll trigger. We set the end value to give enough space for both text and image animations. We use pin to keep the container fixed while scrolling. Next, we animate the description. It moves up 10% and becomes visible. Now it's time to animate the images and the video together. We set Auto Alpha to 1 to make them visible by changing both opacity and visibility. They appear one by one using the stagger effect. The video starts playing when its animation begins. With this sign, the animation starts 3 seconds after the text animation ends. The random positions may not look as visually balanced on smaller devices. To fix this, we create a function that adjusts the random ranges based on screen size. If the screen is less than 600 pixels wide, it returns smaller random values. If the screen is 600 pixels or wider, it returns larger random values. This way, we get responsive random positions with the help of this function. As you can see, it looks more balanced now. And that's it! When we scroll down, the description appears first. The images and video fade in slowly one by one, and each item appears in a random position and angle. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more creative projects. Thanks for watching!